I'm Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Hello, this is Jacob Wilson, and today I'm going to be doing a Fate Reforged cons draft. I just got home from the Pro Tour, where I top 8ed, and I quite enjoy this format. Alright, I opened a very powerful pack. There's Mastery of the Unseen and Pyrotechnics. Pyrotechnics is one of the top uncommons. It's slightly weakened by the fact that it's red, and that red has a lot of weak cards. It's not very deep. Mastery of the Unseen is pretty much an unpassable rare. I would take it. The only cards that I would take over it are other rares. So I'll just snatch that up. Well, this is quite a strong pack. I hope that my opponent didn't open Elite Scale Guard. That would lead to me getting hooked. But I'm just going to take Dragon Scale General. It's not an unbeatable rare. You have to be attacking for it to have some impact on the game. But if you do have tap creatures, like if you curve 2-drop into 3-drop into this, it's basically going to win the game by itself. This pack is very strong, though. There's also Dowsing Gloom, Goblin Heel Cutter, and Harsh Sustenance as premium cards, and a lot of solid cards as well in the pack. Okay, the best card in this pack is Battle Brawler by far. And it's convenient that we're already white, so black-white is one of my favorite archetypes. I think that black-white was the premier archetype in cons, and it was weakened by the addition of Fate Reforged, but not by a lot. I certainly like blue and black more than I did before, so I've drafted a lot of Sultai decks or just blue-black only. Anyways, I'm just going to take Battle Brawler, and likely I'll be a warrior-based deck. Okay, this pack is a big difference from the past few. There's no premium cards in this pack. The best card is probably Dismal Backwater, followed by Frontier Mastodon. Alicia's Vanguard is playable, but not great. I'm not going to take it here. A Vanguard at some point will probably wheel. I'm just going to take the Dismal Backwater. Esper is not a traditional shard, but I don't really care about tradition. Okay, the best cards in this pack are Lotus Path Djinn and Grim Contest. I haven't really seen any white cards besides the first two picks, which scares me and makes me think that maybe the person passing to me took Elite Scale Guard. I'm going to take Lotus Path Djinn. I think Grim Contest is probably slightly better, but it's black and green, so that's just too much of a stray from where I currently am. There's another Dismal Backwater, so I could just be Esper. The next best card in the pack is Ethereal Ambush, but I'm not quite ready to move into blue-green quite yet. Okay, this pack is not very exciting, but I'm going to take Rite of Undoing. It's basically Peel from Reality, but that card's not very good in general. Okay, in this pack there's Jeskai Sage and Hooded Assassin. I think that they're both pretty overrated, and I'd rather not play either. I'll take the Hooded Assassin. It looks like blue and black are the main colors that I've been picking. So I might end up Sultai or just blue and black. Renowned Weaponsmith is fine. I'll just take the Vanguard here, though. This is an incredibly late heal cutter. There's also this, the Sultai Emissary, which is playable and good, but I'm just going to take the heal cutter. There's just so much upside if red happens to be open. Heal cutter is the best red common and probably the best common in the set. Okay, there's a Gore Swine. I guess there's still a chance that I end up Mardu. This pack has been kind of a mess. I don't really plan for my drafts to end up like this, but sometimes they do. Alright, back to Cons of Tarkir. Grim Harsupex is a good card. I think Chief of the Edge is better if you're guaranteed to be a black-white warrior deck. But I really have no idea what's going on. I think that in this pack I'm going to receive a lot of white and red cards. So, I could take the Hordling Outburst, but I think that's too far of a stretch. I think I have to pick between the Harsupex and the Chief. The Harsupex will likely end up in my deck no matter what, so I'm going to hedge and take that. It's also a pretty good card. Like I said, if I was firmly white, black warriors, I would take Chief, but I'm going to take the Harsupex. Alright, this pack is quite weak. I would have been happy to get a land of some kind. The best card for me is either Alabaster Kirin or Treasure Cruise, because I have these lands. Even if I end up Mardu, I can probably play Treasure Cruise. And I'm not too excited about Kirin. It is playable and good, but I'll just take Treasure Cruise. I like all my decks to have at least one good Delve card. Alright, this pack, there's Killshot and Throttle for situational removal, Timely Horde Mate, which I think is very overrated, and Bitter Revelation, which is great. I'm going to take the Bitter Revelation. Ideally, I'll get past a Scoured Barrens or a Nomad Outpost if I'm really lucky. Alright, I'll just take Feet of Resistance. It looks like we're just going to be Esper, which is not really where you want to be in this format. In this pack, I could take Cancel or Water Whirl or a free Weapon Master. Oh, pardon me. Sage Eye Hair is also playable. Alright, I think all the morphs are replaceable. I think Water World's overrated, but I'll still take it. There's another Dismal Backwater. I would have preferred if it were a different land, say Scoured Barrens or Tranquil Cove, but I'll still take it. Ooh, wow, Debilitating Injury. Happy to get that. Jeskai Wind Scout, I'm also happy to get. Looks like I can cut these red cards. The Heal Cutter was just an anomaly. War Behemoth, not really ideal. Abomination of Gadul, if I end up with a green land of some kind. Alright, well, this deck is kind of a pile. But it has some good cards. It looks like my deck is blue-black, mainly, and then I have a couple of very strong white cards that I'm going to be splashing. Maybe not the Feat of Resistance, but definitely the white enchantment, Mastery of the Unseen, and Dragonscale General. Alright, going into Pack 3, I would love to get Tranquil Cove or Scoured Barrens. Alright. You ask and you shall receive. There's a Tranquil Cove. I also wouldn't mind some 2-drops. I'll probably wheel Wetland Sandbar or Mardu Skull Hunter, if I'm lucky. But here I'm happy to take the Tranquil Cove. Okay. I'm pretty short on creatures, so I could take Mystic of the Hidden Way. Or I could take Opulent Palace, and then that will let me splash the Abomination and maybe future green cards as well. I'm going to take the Opulent Palace. Alright, there we go. There's Nomad Outpost as well. I do need to pick up some playables this pack, but I'm just going to take the Nomad Outpost. Or should I take the Abomination? I'll take the Nomad Outpost, and then from this point forward, I really need to get some playables. This can be my last pick that's on a land. Okay, Saddle Brute is fantastic. I'm very lucky to get that so late. Okay, there's Ankle Shanker, which I'll have one source for, or Mistfire Weaver. I think Ankle Shanker is very overrated, and especially in this deck, I don't think it will shine, so I'll take Mistfire Weaver. There's a Freet Weapon Master, which I would have one source for. So I'll just take Soultai Scavenger. It's an excellent card. Here it's between War Behemoth and Sidisi's Pet. I'll take Sidisi's Pet. Nothing too shiny in my sideboard. I need probably at least 2 more playables to go in my deck. Wow, Mardu Rough Rider. That card is so good. Why is it so late? Wow, Mardu is definitely open. That late Ankle Shanker and now the Rough Rider. I think I have to take Wetland Sandbar, unfortunately. Alright, here I pick up another one. Now my deck has somewhat of a reasonable curve. Do I want to play Rugged Highlands in my Esper deck? Not really. I'll take Cancel for my sideboard. Alright, well, I was definitely feeling confident going into the draft, but this is not what I was hoping for. So this is 23 cards plus 6 lands. So I could play 17 lands, or I could play 18. I think this deck wants 18 lands. Given how good the late game is, including a bunch of draw spells. I think I'm either going to want to cut Rite of Undoing or Water Whirl. They're both underwhelming. I'm going to play all these draw spells. They're pretty great. And I've right around the right number of creatures being 15. A lot of my creatures are mediocre, but that's fine. I have a bunch of Delve and Treasure Cruise and Sultai Scavenger. So I guess I'll cut Rite of Undoing and keep the Water Whirl. I think in general, Rite of Undoing is better than Water Whirl. But in this situation, I'll choose to play Water Whirl. Alright, I don't really recommend Esper as the shard you play, but you you should use the tools that are afforded to you, and that's what I'm going to do. Alright, so amongst my dual lands, there are already 5 black sources, so four more will make 9, and there are 5 blue, so 4 more will make 9. There are 2 white, 3 more will make 5. I don't think I need a forest. I think I can afford to play one more of a different color. Given that my green card is just a morph. I think 9 black and 9 blue is plenty. I'll just play one more plains. Mastery of the Unseen is sort of a double colored card in the late game. Alright, I'll be back for round 1.